हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, स्टैंडर्ड 8, वी स्टार्टेड द रिवीजन फॉर द चैप्टर नंबर 1, दैट इज रेशनल नंबर्स। इन लास्ट फ्यू सेशंस वी लर्न द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रेशनल नंबर्स एज वेल एज सम properties of rational number like closure property and commutativity and associativity. Now before we learn the last property, distributivity, we need to learn some other facts. So today we are going to learn about the role of zero, the role of number one, then the negative of a number, or it is also known as additive inverse, and at the last there will be reciprocal of the number or the multiplicative inverse of the number. So let's start with the role of zero. Now can you tell me, if I give you a rational number, say 3/5, 3/5 is a rational number. Now if I add a zero to 3/5, what answer will I get? Obviously 3/5 itself. Second, if I add -9/7 into 0, means 0 plus -9/7, what answer will I get? Obviously, -9/7 itself. So, in any rational number, if you take any rational number and you add 0 in it, then you will get that same rational number back. And it is true for any of the rational numbers. And therefore, 0 is called the identity for the addition of rational number, or it is known as additive identity, identity for addition or additive identity. It means that for any rational numbers, A, doesn't matter then it is a positive rational number or a negative rational number, but if you add 0 in it, means for any rational numbers A, A plus 0 is equal to 0 plus A is equal to A itself. And you notice in the previous standards also that 0 is the additive identity for the integers and whole numbers also. So it is not only the additive identity for rational numbers, because we learned in the previous standards that 5 plus 0 is also 5, minus 9 plus 0 is also minus 9 again, and so on. So 0 is the additive identity for rational numbers as well as for whole numbers, for integers, for natural numbers, etc. So that is the fact about the zero, that the zero is known as the additive identity for rational numbers, whole numbers, or the integers. Now the role of one. When you learn multiplication in the beginning, You started with tables. What is the first statement of the tables? Any tables? 15 ones are 15, 17 ones are 17, 19 ones are 19. So you learn that when you multiply any number with 1, you get the same number back. So for the rational numbers also, it is true. It means when we multiply any rational numbers with 1, then we get the same number as an answer. Means 3 by 7 multiplied by 1, we get 3 by 7 only. Minus 12 upon 19 multiplied by 1, then you get minus 12 upon 19 again. So we can say that 1 is the multiplicative identity or identity for multiplication. So 1 is the multiplicative identity for rational numbers. And this is true for any of the rational numbers. Positive rational numbers or negative rational number, but except 0. Actually, for 0 also, 0 multiplied by 1 is also 0. So it is true for any rational numbers. So we can write down, for any rational number A, you A multiply by 1, or you do 1 multiplied by A, then you will get the same answer as A. And note that 1 is the multiplicative identity for integers and whole numbers also. Because we know that minus 7 multiplied by 1 is also minus 7, and so on. Now we have to learn about the negative of a number, or it is also known as additive inverse of the number. For example, if A upon B is our rational numbers, then when you change the sign, means if it is positive, then take negative. So if the negative of a rational number A by B is minus A upon B. And similarly, the negative of minus A upon B is A upon B. And when you add them, A by B plus minus A upon B, the addition will be 0. So we can say that when the addition of two numbers is 0, then both the numbers are said to be additive inverse of each other. For example, if you take a number 4 upon 9, then what is the additive inverse of it? Obviously, minus 4 upon 9. And when you add 4 upon 9 plus minus 4 upon 9, you will get the answer 0. It means that 4 by 9 and minus 4 by 9 are additive inverse of each other. If you take minus 15 upon 27, then minus 15 upon 27, in which you add 15 upon 27, will be 0. It means that minus 15 upon 27 is additive inverse of 15 upon 27, and 15 upon 27 is the additive inverse of the other one. So means both numbers who have different sign, one have positive sign, the other will have negative sign, then they are said to be the additive inverse of each other. Then the last is the reciprocal of a number. So now when we get two rational numbers such that their product is 1, it means that when we multiply two rational numbers and the product is 1, then they are known as reciprocals of each other. If you take the number 9 upon 7, then if you multiply it with 7 upon 9, then 9, 9 and 7, 7 can be cancelled. Your answer is 1. It means that 7 by 9 is the reciprocal of 9 upon 7 and 9 upon 7 is the reciprocal of 7 upon 9. Similarly, minus 29 upon 31 and 31 minus 31 upon 29. So when we multiply them, negative, negative, positive, and the reciprocals, I mean the numerators and denominator will be cancelled with each other. So they are also called the reciprocals of each other. And reciprocals are also known as the multiplicative inverse. So 3 by 7 is the multiplicative inverse of 7 by 3. Can you tell me what is the reciprocal of 1? The reciprocal of 1 is 1 itself. Similarly, reciprocal of minus 1 is also minus 1 itself. But can you tell me the reciprocal of 0? 1 upon 0 is not possible. And therefore, we can say that only one rational number is such that it does not have any reciprocal, and that is the number 0. 0 does not have reciprocal because division by 0 is not possible. Now, the last and the most important property for rational numbers, and that is the distributivity of multiplication over addition and subtraction. So here, this is the very, very, very important property which will be used in mathematics as long as you learn mathematics, or in the engineering, wherever you use mathematics, this property will be there with you. So you have to be very careful about learning it. So when three rational numbers A, B and C are given, then the first multiplication over addition means A multiplied by bracket B plus C. So here multiplication will be distributed, look here, over the addition. Mean the number outside the bracket A will be multiplied with both of them inside. Means A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. Or you can write down as AB plus AC also. You can write down as AB plus AC. Similarly, the distribution of multiplication over subtraction also there. in which a multiplied by into bracket b minus c. Then also we have to do the same thing, a will be multiplied with both of them, means a multiplied by b or ab minus a multiplied by c, means ac. So these are the two statements for the distributivity of multiplication over addition and subtraction. So a multiplied by b plus c is equal to ab plus ac, and a multiplied by b minus c is equal to ab minus ac. For example, 3 by 5 multiplied by 7 by 5 plus 9 by 5. Then this 3 by 5 will be multiplied with both of them, means 3 by 5 into 7 by 5 plus 3 by 5 multiplied by 9 by 5. And then we have to simplify. Similarly, for the negative also, subtraction. So 9 by 16 into bracket 8 by 3 minus 5 by 3. Then 9 by 16 will be multiplied with both of them. 9 by 16 multiplied by 8 by 3 and minus 9 by 6 multiplied by 5 upon 3. So here we finished all the properties of the rational numbers. So we are going to finish the session. In next session, we will start some examples based on this all the properties, so that how to apply the different properties to find out the answers. This will be followed by the PDF, and if any confusion, write down for the comment section. Thank you very much.